Hello, my name is Frank Silverman, the Executive Director of the Martial Arts Industry Association, and you're watching another Business is Business video. My next two Business is Business videos are going to be based on an event we just did in LA, a success seminar, an elite seminar, and a topic that came up. And the topic was new members. So I want to talk to you first about the question that came up. Somebody had asked the question, hey, I'm not seeing a lot of action from my advertising. I'd like to get some ideas of how to get new members from external marketing, not from my current student base. So my first question was, I didn't understand why he wanted to do that. So I asked the question, well, why do you want to get new members from marketing and advertising as opposed to from referrals and events at your school? And his answer was, well, because I think I've tapped that already. So number one, that's a whole nother conversation. I don't think you can ever tap referrals or tap out from referrals, because essentially if people are excited about your program and they like what's going on, they want to refer people, and people have the people they work with, their friends, their neighbors, their families. But here is what I went through with this instructor. I said, let me ask you this, how much does it cost to run an ad wherever you run an ad? And he gave me an example of a local magazine that he runs an ad. And I said, well, how much does it cost? And his answer was very quick. He says, $500 every month. I said, well, if you $500 every month, how many people do you hope to get from that ad? And I get two people. If I get two people, I'm happy. I said, so let me make sure I understand this. If you run an ad for $500 a month, you hope you get two people, which means on occasions you may only get one. And of course, his response was, on occasions I get zero. But so using that number, that means when he runs this ad that he's happy with, according to him, he's spending between $250 and $500 to get a new member, just from that ad. So let me show you why. He runs the ad, spends $500, gets one new member, $500 to get that new member. So, and that's a guarantee that he's going to spend that money. If he gets nobody to sign up, he just threw out $500. So I wasn't suggesting that he doesn't run the ad, but I was suggesting, well, what happens if you throw a birthday party? I said, do you ever throw birthday parties? He says, yes. How much do you charge? $99, which by the way I think is a little low, but he charges $99. I said, if you do a real good birthday party, how many signups do you get? He says, well, usually I'll get one signup if I follow up with the people. I said, now let me make sure I have this right. If you do a birthday party and you get a signup from there, essentially you got paid $99 to actually get that member. Would I prefer to pay $500 to get a member, or get paid $99 to get a member? That was example one. Example two was, well, let's do a referral program. And we have a big event and we ask everybody to bring their friends, and if their friends sign up, they get $50 gift card anywhere they want, or even $100 gift card to our pro shop. So now, if we invite all of our school to participate in this and three people sign up, it's a unique opportunity here, because unlike spending the $500, if we have this party and nobody signs up, it didn't cost us anything and we actually probably had a really good retention event. But if people do sign up and I end up giving them all $100 to our pro shop, that's $300 that we know in our pro shop probably only costs us $150. For three students, that's $50 a student. So I explained in the seminar that the very best new members, the very best new members come from referrals or come from events that we host in our school because of our current membership. How about community events? Do you ever do a drug awareness event that maybe is not about referrals, but it's a community event for drug awareness or bullying, where people come in, maybe schools, or you pass out your flyers, whatever it is, people come in and then they sign up, and maybe we give them a discount on their membership. But again, if I do that, the discount is probably less than the cost if I ran an ad. And number two, I don't give any money away unless I get a sign up, unlike a paid ad. So there's a time and a place for paid ads, don't get me wrong. First, I think they should be inexpensive. Two, I think if you do paid ads, you need to be on agreements that are not long-term, because after 2 or 3 months, if they're not working, you need to cease and desist running those ads. But mostly I want to convey that internal marketing that are tied to family members and friends are your best students. They cost less to acquire a new member, they typically stay longer, and candidly, they're easy to go through the sign-up procedure because they came as a referral, not as a sales presentation. Next week, I'm going to talk to you about how we count or who we count as a new member.